The iPad Air 4th Gen is now about 3 years old, but of course it got the new iPadOS 17 update. Most videos you'll find on the internet about iPadOS 17 will be on newer iPad or iPad Pro models, so I wanted to show you guys what it's like on an older model like this one. I also made a video about iOS 17 on the iPhone 13, but if you haven't watched it yet, go check it out and subscribe to the channel too so you get more content like this. Since this is a pre-M1 iPad, we're not getting any Stage Manager updates here, but these older iPads are still getting several helpful changes that a lot of users will appreciate. Let me show you what's actually new, starting with lock screen customizations. Lock screen customization was a big thing for iPhones when iOS 16 launched, but it really didn't make it onto iPadOS 16. Now it's here with iPadOS 17, you can customize your clock style, color, and font. You can also put live photo wallpapers on here, which helps personalize the experience. I like to play with these a ton whenever I find and set a new wallpaper, so I'm pretty excited it finally made its way onto the iPad. You can also put widgets on here, including the new interactive widgets. Yep, just like iOS 17, iPad is also getting interactive widgets on both the home screen and the lock screen. Just like you always could on Android, you can now directly interact with widgets without opening their source apps. This is super convenient since you can just directly check things off from a checklist, play or change audio tracks, scrolling through your calendar, and more to come as third-party developers update their apps. No matter the iPad model, iPads are not getting standby view, which is kind of a bummer since that honestly seems like a better fit for iPad. But whatever, I'm happy we're finally getting interactive widgets on both iOS and iPadOS. Next is finally some good native PDF editing on your iPad. PDFs were always kind of awkward on iPadOS. I've always been using free third-party PDF editors or even buying some to edit, fill out, or sign PDFs. But now we're getting some better native support on iPad. iPadOS now recognizes text boxes so you can fill in blanks. You can also integrate these docs into your notes app so you can annotate and mark them up freely. Through notes, you can even do some live edits with someone else, which is pretty convenient for students and for the few of you that have IT teams that actually employ and manage iPads. Then there's the updated messages. This app probably isn't used as often as it is on iPhone, but there's still a lot of little changes here that make things a lot more user-friendly. Like on other popular messaging apps, you can finally swipe right on a message to send an inline message. There's also the auto-deletion of two-factor code messages. Now you don't have to sift through a bunch of expired 2FA messages. iPadOS will automatically just delete them for you. This feature is going to work for both messages and the mail apps. I don't use the mail app, but if you do, good for you. Next is Safari, which is finally getting some power user features to make life a little easier. Like you can on any other major browser on desktops, you can finally create different profiles on Safari. For example, you can have one for personal use and one for work. With profiles, you can keep your use cases totally separate. Safari is going to separate cookies, history, tag groups, and all that per profile. If you take your personal iPad to work or school for class notes and meetings, this is pretty neat to keep things separate. Incognito or private browsing is also getting some little improvements. You can now lock a private window with Face or Touch ID so you don't have to worry about anyone peeping in whatever you're doing. Last but not least is the Apple Health app, which was weirdly never available on iPad until now. It's the same content that's synced from your iPhone and Apple Watch, but you can now look at all the graphs and data with a nice tablet UI on a big screen. I've personally never locked my mood on an iPhone, but yeah, if you do that, you can do that here too. Apparently, developers can use a HealthKit API to improve their iPad apps if there's any health integration, so that's nice. Okay, so those were some of the biggest changes that came to older iPad models with iPadOS 17. Just like iOS 17, iPadOS 17 doesn't bring any massive visual changes to the iPad, but besides Stage Manager, I'm happy even this old iPad Air is basically getting all the other improvements just like the newer iPad models. Okay, that's going to do it for this video. Let me know in the comments if you updated and how your experience has been so far with iPadOS 17. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.